After installing firmware update 4.30.10, the LG CX or C10 now supports 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming from the Xbox Series X. But did you know there are at least 6 new features that were not mentioned in the firmware release notes, which didn't even mention 4K 120Hz Dolby Vision gaming in the first place? The first feature is that Dolby Vision game mode is now more accurate. On the previous firmware version of 3.23.35, if I reset my calibrated Dolby Vision game mode so that the default out-of-the-box picture settings are restored, you can see that once I go into the white balance submenu, the default color temperature is medium, which is far too cool, introducing a blue cast to everything on screen. However, on the latest firmware of 4.30.10, if I reset the picture settings in Dolby Vision game mode, and again go into the white balance submenu to check, you can see that the default color temperature is now warm too, which is much closer to the D65 white point used within the film and broadcast and increasingly gaming industry. The second undocumented feature is that AMD FreeSync Premium and Dolby Vision are no longer mutually exclusive. On previous firmwares prior to 4.30.10, engaging AMD FreeSync Premium on any HDMI port would disable Dolby Vision for that input. As you can see, once I got out from the user menu of this LG CX and then went into the 4K TV details information screen on the Xbox Series X, Dolby Vision support would be removed once AMD FreeSync Premium was engaged. This has changed with firmware 4.30.10. Even after I enable AMD FreeSync Premium on an HDMI input, I could still get Dolby Vision even up to 4K 120Hz, judging from the Xbox information screen, so you might as well leave AMD FreeSync Premium engaged at all times. Undocumented feature number 3 is that LG has fixed the FreeSync information bar to correctly display the HDMI 2.1 frame rate. Previously, 4K 120Hz games would for some reason be reported to be running at 5.5Hz, give and take. But after installing firmware 4.30.10, the fluctuations close to 120Hz in VRR mode would be accurately reported by the FreeSync information bar, which, if you are not already aware, can be summoned by quickly pressing the green button on your LG Magic Remote multiple times. While on the subject of pressing buttons on your remote control, undocumented feature number 4 is that you can now turn off the no signal message on a blank source input, allowing you to see a series of beautiful screensavers without an annoying message floating about on screen. To hide the no signal message, simply press the red button on your remote control on a blank input, and to bring back the no signal message, just press the red button again. Undocumented feature number 5 is that LG has increased the default light output in SDR Filmmaker mode. On previous firmware versions, the default OLED light in SDR Filmmaker mode on the LG CX or C10 OLED has always been 25, as proven after resetting the picture settings in Filmmaker mode, which delivered around 80 nits peak white for SDR or standard dynamic range content. Perhaps due to too many complaints from owners that Filmmaker mode is too dim, LG has used firmware 4.30.10 to increase the default OLED light value in Filmmaker mode to 80, which resulted in a peak white close to 200 nits, which is similar to the default light output on Samsung televisions in Filmmaker mode. While this brighter Filmmaker mode may appeal to some users, if you are a videophile who prefers to watch in reference SDR conditions, you can drop OLED light to 35, which delivered a peak white of 100 nits on our 48-inch LG CX sample. I measured my unit before and after installing the new firmware, and didn't detect any significant difference in near-black gamma tracking or HDR peak brightness. The graphs with the new firmware version of 4.30.10 appeared marginally brighter overall, because by that time, the OLED panel had heated up so much from undergoing so many measurements in different picture modes. SDR Filmmaker mode, HDR Filmmaker mode, HDR game mode, Dolby Vision mode. What happens when black frame insertion or BFI was engaged? All with 56-point grayscale measurements and more. Some of you previously complained that I wasn't doing enough firmware analysis on the LG CX or C10 OLED, but you have to understand that I have to go through my entire testing process. It's like reviewing another television altogether. And if I find no difference, all the time and effort to source another review sample and perform all these tests would have been wasted, when I could be reviewing another new television or making new videos. That's why I can only afford to carry out firmware analysis for the ones that I know will definitely bring important new features, such as this 4K 100Hz Dolby Vision gaming one. Anyway, in the picture menu, there's also a new minimum brightness slider after installing firmware 4.30.10. This setting only becomes active once you set energy saving to auto, and what this slider does is to let you set a limit so that the light output doesn't drop below a certain threshold in automatic energy saving mode. To explain, if you engage energy saving and set it to auto, the LG CX or C10 will automatically adjust the light output depending on the amount of ambient lighting detected by the light sensor on the television. If you decrease minimum brightness to zero, this will allow the energy saving algorithm to dim the screen to the darkest level as deemed necessary according to detected ambient lighting. Whereas if you increase minimum brightness to 10, the energy saving dimming won't be as aggressive. In any case, I always advise you to turn off energy saving on any television, including the LG CX or C10, for the most consistent light output and color accuracy, so there is no need for you to worry about this minimum brightness slider at all. Oh, one thing about playing games in 4K 100Hz Dolby Vision on the Xbox Series X is that some of you may be concerned that you are only getting 8-bit YCBCR 422 in Dolby Vision mode, instead of 10-bit RGB output in HDR10. This is correct and there's nothing wrong with your television or your Xbox Series X. The reason why it's showing as 8-bit YCBCR 422 is because the Xbox Series X uses the low latency or source lag version of Dolby Vision, which is transmitted via a 12-bit YCBCR 422 video signal. However, any 422 package, be it 8-bit, 10-bit or 12-bit, will look the same to a sync device such as a television. And conservatively, LG TVs including the CX will report it as 8-bit YCBCR 422, when in actual fact it's 12-bit YCBCR 422, so there's nothing to worry about from your end. To find out if you should play games in Dolby Vision or stick with HDR10 on the Xbox Series X, I've demonstrated the benefits and downsides for both formats in my Dolby Vision vs. HDR10 gaming side-by-side comparison video here.